Mother broke daughter's spine to make her dance well, then made her into a personal music box. Today I will introduce a French supernatural horror film called Livid to all you guys. At the bus stop with a lot of notices from missing girl, there's a little girl called Lucy today. Lucy starts her practical training as an at-home nurse. She is trained by an older lady, Mrs. Wilson. Not long after Mrs. Wilson came to pick her up in the car, she looked into Lucy's eyes. It said that there are two souls in the body of two different colored eyes, but Lucy didn't want to talk too much, because she told her boyfriend to catch up in the evening. Therefore, she just wanted to finish the work quickly. The last patient on their rounds lives in an old remote mansion. The nurse said the patient was a little tricky and asked Lucy to wait for her in the car. But this is a horror film. If Lucy sits obediently in the car, what else is there to see? Instead of listening to the Mrs. Wilson, Lucy gets off the car and steps into the manor. Lucy enters the mansion, which is filled with stuffed animals, and finds Mrs. Wilson at the bed of the patient, Mrs. Deborah Jessel. Mrs. Wilson doesn't blame Lucy for seeing her. Wilson tells her that Jessel was once a prominent ballet teacher, but is now bedridden and in a coma because of her daughter's accidental death. There is a rumor that Mrs. Jessel has a treasure of gold and jewels located somewhere on the property. Lucy finds that the key is on the Jessel's neck and it not liquid medicine. It led Lucy asked Mrs. Wilson that what going on, but she ignored after her first day on the job. Lucy tells her boyfriend Will about the treasure. When her boyfriend hears of the treasure, he's very interested in that. He wants to steal the treasure and then the two of you will run away together. But Lucy finds that it's hard and unacceptable to take the money from a bedridden woman. Lucy comes back home and see her father's talking with his young girlfriend. She hears their conversation. She can't help thinking of her mother who died because of her father's adultery. She doesn't want to live with that woman. So she calls her boyfriend and agrees to steal the treasure. Then they can find an apartment and move out. Lucy, Will and Will's brother Ben decide to hunt for the treasure in a room filled with stuffed animals gathered around a tea table. They find a single locked door. Lucy correctly suspects that a key worn by Jessel is the key to this door. Inside, they find a white sheet covering what looks like a stuffed mannequin of a young girl. Lucy suggests that this is the corpse of Jessel's mute daughter Anna, still dressed in a ballerina outfit. Lucy twists the key on the pedestal the corpse is standing on, and the corpse starts spinning slowly with music playing like a ballerina on a music box. A strange voice makes her boyfriend very afraid, so he breaks the girl's neck impulsively. They hear the footsteps came from upstairs. They know that there's only Jessel in the house, but she's still bedridden. They try to flee the house, but the window through which they entered is now secured by iron bars. Lucy had to take them away from the window of Jessel's room, but they didn't think that Jessel was missing, and the window couldn't be opened. While trying to find an exit, they become separated. Will's friend wasn't here, and they didn't know where he is. Will began to pick this lock and Lucy began to observe the Jessel's room. They found Jessel and her daughter in the picture on the desk. Jessel suddenly go missing. The puppet box in the basement and they couldn't get out of here. All these doubts aroused Lucy's curiosity. She went back the room of the puppet box again. Lucy sees Mrs. Jessel sitting at what was once Anna's tea party table. She slowly put her hand on Lucy's hand. There is a flashback demonstrating that Mrs. Jessel was a very strict ballet teacher. The girl leaves the ballet class and Jessel later finds her lying dead in Anna's room. Anna is bent over the girl, drinking her blood. It is revealed that the Jessels are vampires. Once she left after sucking blood and Jessel brought her back. It turns out that she couldn't meet her mother's requirements because she didn't practice dance seriously. She was trampled to break her spine when she was in the low back and made into a puppet. When Lucy opened her eyes again, Mrs. Jessel was gone, but she heard the voice of Ben. Then she ran out in a hurry. Lucy saw Mrs. Jessel was attacking and killing her boyfriend, and Ben is covered with blood and falls beside him. Lucy discovers that Anna is not dead, but Mrs. Wilson appears, attacks and sedates her. When Lucy wakes up, she finds herself strapped to the operating table. It turns out that Mrs. Wilson was a student of Mrs. Jessel. She is brainwashed to become a loyal henchman in order to get blood for Mrs. Jessel. She had harmed a lot of girls. While Wilson watched, Mrs. Jessel implants the pupae of a moth into the throats of Lucy. Jesse and Anna. This is a ritual to exchange their soul. Jessel believes that she has been successful. When Anna awakes and her eye color has changed and she is in a different body, Wilson attempts to punish her, but Anna stabs her with scissors and then turns on Jessel. Lucy whips her mother until she releases Anna, and the two girls throw Jessel off a third floor balcony. Anna and Lucy escape from the mansion and walk along the seaside holding hands. Lucy and Anna's body leans over the cliff, but she does not fall. Instead, she flies into the sky. Her scars disappear, and Anna in Lucy's body watches her float away. That's the end of the film, but many audiences may be confused. Why does the resurrected Anna want to kill her mother? Why does Lucy want to commit suicide? And is soul exchange really success? It all starts with Lucy's different eyes. In fact, there are two souls in her body. One of them is Lucy, the other is her dead mother, who is guarding her in the dark. During the soul exchange, Lucy's mother entered Anna's body, so her eyes color returned to normal. Or maybe it's because Lucy still has her own soul in her body, so Anna couldn't get in and had to stay in her own body. From then on, Anna had her own soul and Lucy's mother's soul. That's the reason why she killed Mrs. Jessel and Mrs. Wilson. But maybe she resented that her mother had bound herself for too long. In the end, she jumped down and got the freedom and liberation she had been longing. Two mothers in the movie, they all treat their daughters in very different ways. Anna's mother is over control, but Lucy's mother is like a guardian under the control of morbid state. Anna is more and more extreme, and Lucy survived thanks to her mother's protection. She becomes strong and calm to fight with evil side.